In the first video of the Adobe Illustrator for Amazon KDP tutorial series, I just made a simple introduction to Adobe Illustrator's start page and showed how to set up your document size for Amazon KDP. In this video, you will learn how to create these professionally designed line pages in Adobe Illustrator. As I said in the previous video, these Amazon KDP tutorials are for beginners and there is no need to have any previous knowledge about Adobe Illustrator. Firstly, if you don't have Adobe Illustrator, just watch the video to see how it is easy to do it with some tips and tricks. Then, get your 7-day free trial and try to do it. Don't worry, I will walk you through the steps in this tutorial series. The 7-day free trial link is below in the description. Let's dive in. Before we start, let me introduce you to the workspace of Illustrator quickly. There are different workspace presets for different workflows. Here, if you click Window and then Workspace, you see that Illustrator provides you 9 different workspaces. When you first open Illustrator, your workspace probably looks different than mine, because the default workspace is Essentials. But as you see, I prefer to use the painting option. So if you click the painting option here, your workspace will look the same as mine. Okay, the workspace of Illustrator can be separated into different parts. Let me show each of them to you. On the top, you see the header. You can find all menus here. File, Edit, Object, Type, Select, Effects, View, Window, and Help menus. Just under the header, we have the Control Panel. The Control Panel offers quick access to options related to the objects you select. For example, in addition to options for changing the color and dimensions of the object, if you select the text object on the left side, the Control Panel displays text formatting options like character and paragraph. Below the Control Panel, we have the Document tabs. Here, you can see the name of the files that you open. Most of the time, you may work on different files together, so you can switch them here by clicking. On the left side, we have the Toolbar. It includes a selective set of tools that you frequently use while working on Illustrator. If you hover the mouse over a tool, it shows the name of it, its shortcut, and a small video explaining what it does. If there is a small triangle in the corner, right-click on the mouse to view the hidden tools, and then click the tool you want to select. On the right side, we have the panels. If you remember, we chose painting as a workspace. That's why you see the swatch options here. Also, you can perform different actions, like changing the dimensions of the objects or aligning them. On the bottom, there is a status bar. You can see the zoom level here. Lastly, this one is an artboard in the center. The gray part is the scratch space. You can put some stuff here. However, only the stuff in the white area will show up when the document is printed out. Okay, that's it. Don't worry, you will be familiar with all after spending some time with Illustrator. Let's draw our first line. Click the Line Segment tool on the left side. Then, click somewhere to start on the artboard. Hold and drag it. If you hold the Shift key at the same time, you can draw straight lines. So, hold the Shift key and release. Our first line is ready. Now, we have to arrange the width of this line. To avoid any blank space on the artboard, we should make the width of this line equal to the width of our artboard. To do it, click the selection tool on the left side and select the line. There is a small window called Transform on the right side. If you don't have it, just click the window and select Transform. We can arrange the position of the line on the X and Y coordinate here. Besides this, The width and height of the selected object can be changed in the small transform window. Firstly, let's move our line to 1 inch on the Y coordinate. Then, write 6.125 for the width. As you see, some part of the line is out of the artboard. And if we print like this, this part will not be visible. Therefore, we have to make the position of the line exactly in the middle of the artboard. There is a horizontal align center option on the control panel. Again, if you don't have this above or a small align window on the right menu, click Window and click Align. If you click horizontal align center, you can place the line perfectly in the middle of the artboard. So the position of our line looks good. Now, let's arrange the color and thickness of it also quickly. Select the line and choose 0.75 for the stroke weight to make the line thinner. And change the color of it to gray, which will look better on the notebook papers. If you double click the swatch, you can see the color parameters here. Let's make a college ruled notebook. When you write college ruled in your title or subtitle, you have to be sure about the vertical space between the top and bottom horizontal lines. The college ruled paper has 9/32 inches spacing between horizontal lines. By dividing 9 by 32, we can find the space between the horizontal lines. It is 0.28125 inches. Okay, let's create our second horizontal line. It's quite easy with a keyboard shortcut. Select the line and then press Ctrl, Shift and M. Here, you can change the position of the selected object horizontally and vertically. As the spacing between the horizontal lines is 0.28125 inches for college ruled paper, write 0.28125 in the vertical box. As you see, it is rounding the number to 4 digits after the dot. And it shows the space as 0.2813. But it's okay, because Adobe Illustrator considers the 5th digit in its calculations in the background. If you click Preview here, you can see how your line will move. In this window, you can both move the selected object and copy and move it at the same time. So if you click copy here, you can create the second line. Okay, now we have the second line. Let's control if it was moved correctly or not. If you select both lines and check the height on the transform window, you see that it is 0.2813. So it works quite well. Okay, now we will duplicate this line as much as we want to complete our college ruled paper. To do it, select the second line. Then press Ctrl D. It's a shortcut for reapplying a transformation to an object. Okay, do it until you have some space at the bottom of the page. Let's control the spacing again for the new lines. Select two lines randomly and check the height in the transform window. It is 0.2813. Perfect. Normally, college ruled papers have vertical margins. However, this is more common in bigger trim sizes like 8.5 by 11. Therefore, I will skip it. Okay, our college ruled paper is ready. Now, let's make a PDF file with 100 pages to upload on Amazon KDP and test it. Click File, then New. If you watched the first video of this tutorial series, you should be familiar with this window. Now, we will increase the number of artboards from 1 to 100. You can do it from here. But we need to make one more small setting to make things easier in the future. Click Advanced Options here, and then click More Settings. Type 100 for the number of artboards, and 0 for the spacing. You can keep the rest as it is. Then click Create Document. Now we have 100 artboards, which means 100 pages. All we need to do is copying our lined page to all these artboards. Click the first file on the Document tab. Select all the lines with the selection tool. Then right-click and select Group to group them. Now you can move them together, up or down, wherever you want. Right-click again and click Copy. Then click the second file on the Document tab and click Edit on the header. Then click Paste on all artboards. Okay. As you see, now our line pages are ready. To upload this file to Amazon KDP, we need to save it as a PDF file. When you do this, this window appears. Click the Adobe PDF preset on the top and select High Quality Prints. Then, unclick the Preserve Illustrator Editing Capabilities, Save PDF. Read and click OK on this warning message. If you open the PDF file, as you see, it looks great. Let's check it in the KDP platform also to see if there is any formatting issue when we upload it. Okay. As you see, there is no problem. It is ready to be published. As I just tried to show you, creating line pages in Adobe Illustrator for Amazon KDP is not complicated. If you haven't tried it before, I suggest you give it a chance and get your 7-day free trial from the link below in the description. We will learn how to create a cover for this file in the following video of this series. I hope this video was worth watching. If you think so, make sure to subscribe and like the video to support the channel. Thanks for watching. See you soon.